three volleys to represent duty, honor, and country. On behalf of American Legion, both my aides, I present you with three casings to receive.
Thank you.
Please accept this presidential memorial certificate for your service rendered by the It's our honor. Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our committal service with full military honors. Please take a little bit of time and just converse amongst yourself. And of course, if there's anybody that would like to say a few kind words, now would be the time.
I know Vicki remembers.
Remember when we were kids and Vicki played hide and seek with us? We were little.
Yeah, that's what I remember about him. And he had the gift of gab.
He sure did.
Because I would talk to him. I could talk to him on the phone for hours. He never had, you know, we always had something to talk about. But anyway, that's what I remember about him.
Chicken sandwich and a bowl of cola ready for us to eat.
Seek or an airplane stories, you know, for you guys that may or may not know, he had a plane, he had two planes, and he spent a lot of time with Phil Barnberger. This is a good friend of his back here, and he and Phil logged a lot of hours flying around, and you know, just being friends. And like I said, Uncle Mike had the gift of gab. It didn't matter who you were, he could talk.
It wasn't a stranger. He never met a stranger.
No.
Like my dad.
He would walk into Hoods or Home Depot and just walk up to somebody and just start talking.
Harmonicas. They like to play harmonicas. Him and Mom. I forgot that one.
Yeah, he played him and all of them.
All of them.
Yeah.
And I still have one harmonicas they gave me.
I got a whole bag full of harmonicas.
I got one.
Yeah, he was a pretty special guy. Thank you for taking care of him.
You're welcome.
Got something to say, baby girl?
I'm Phil Bamberger. I was a friend of Mike for many years. We flew aircraft together. And anyway, he used to help me out a lot in business. He flew parts around for me and actually flew some of my customers when they were from out of town. I was talking to Joe and people here when I got here. I said, "Where's his boots at?" should have brought his boots. He always had those boots on.
Yes, he did. Yes.
Anyway, he is a good man. I here to pay my respects to you guys. And
Gentlemen, that concludes our service. service here at Jefferson Barracks National Cemetery. I appreciate everybody getting up to speak. It's not easy. I've been doing this several times a day for the last 10 years. I can't do it. So good on the people that came up and can do it. Unfortunately, we're going to have another service. They're already lining up here to come to this service. So we will ask you to go to your cars at this time.
I came by today to see you. Oh, I had to let you know. If I knew the last time that I held you was the last time, I'd have held you and never let go. Oh, it's kept me awake nights wondering. I lie in the dark just asking. Heaven was needing a hero, somebody just like you, brave enough to stand up for what. Try to make it make sense in my mind. The only conclusion I come to is heaven was needing a hero like you. Just be void. No matter how much I need you now, heaven needed you more. 'Cause heaven was needing a hero, somebody just like stand up for what you believe and follow it through. When I try to make it make sense in my I came by today to see you. Oh, I had to let you know. If I knew the last time that I held you was the last time, I'd have held you and never let go. It's kept me awake nights wondering. I lie in the dark just asking why. I've always been told you won't be called home until it's your time. I guess heaven was near. Somebody just like you. to stand up for what you believe and follow it through. When I try to make it make sense in my mind, the only conclusion I come to is a heaven. Just be